In 2018, for example, over $100 million was invested in 53 fintechs in Nigeria. These organizations, that ecosystem is scaling in a way we don't expect. You can't stop innovation. All you need to do is, how do you make sure that without so much involvement, and that's where the government is coming in, that's where the policy, the makers and the regulations are going to come in. And that's what Bella was talking about, connectivity across African regions, shared infrastructure, so much that these individuals can come into the system and they could produce what we want. And over time, in terms of standardization, and is it up to what we really want? I think over time we'll get there.
We'll get there. Yeah. Right. Bella, do you think our innovators are ready to collaborate, or we are all in the competing mode? I want to be better than you. I want to be the first one to have actually done this innovation, as we move real quick.
Say that it's natural for any business to be competitive. I mean, we are in business to stay ahead and crush our competitors in terms of what we generate in revenue, but we need to collaborate. You know, collaboration is that means that spurs economic growth and posterity. So I would say that there isn't that beat you down, you know, sort of system going on. There's a lot of collaboration going on in technology, and that's what's going to be the engine for the digital economy to move forward.
All right, Sylvie, when it comes to ecosystem, I want to hear your thoughts. Moving forward, where do we go from here? How do we ensure that we are consuming locally preferential treatment, or everybody compete on the same ground, whether you're African or not? We don't care. Is it what's a very concern?
Well, I guess I'll keep dialing us back to the customer, I guess, because I'm a customer officer. So that's where we start and end. In terms of identifying what's the opportunity and then whether it's been successful, whatever it is that you roll out. I mean, the reality has to be, if we have to embrace digital, digital is not the work of the IT people in the organization. It's a whole mindset shift. Digital is disrupting the boundaries that have previously existed there. It is bringing in new competitors into the space. So today we don't just compete with our traditional telcos, but we are competing with all these new people who are coming with additional services that they're offering to our consumers. So it's important that we create the ecosystem. The ecosystem has a lot to do with the capabilities that we build, right? If I listen to the other panelists and what they're talking about, we can't continue to spur innovation if we don't have the right skill sets, if we don't have the right capabilities, if we don't stretch the imagination of our young people. We talk about Africa having the biggest dividend in terms of the young people in this continent. These young people are growing up in a digital world. They're digital natives. When I look at how the young people today interact with devices, it's very different. It's very native to them. They should be learning things like coding when they're in school, so that they can then begin to figure out, for all the challenges that we have, what are the solutions that we develop for this digital world. So it's imperative that we create that ecosystem. There's a work that the private sector has to do. There's a work that the public sector has to do. There's a work that we have to do as humans, right? Empowering on this generation, because if we do that, then I think we'll create a generation that will truly change Africa.
Because I want to open the floor now, I see several people who want to also ask a few questions or do some deliberations. I'll just give you real quick to just intervene on this.
Yes, just on that, actually, I was talking about the foundation, just to make sure that we can have these digital champions. First foundation that I talked about was connectivity, and at Telco we are working on that. But there are also other foundations that are needed. Digital literacy, this is key. This is why in Sonatel we have launched in Dakar a free coding school where we're welcoming young people between 18 and 30, and we plan to have it also with other operations. It's about also the ecosystem. The ecosystem, we have a lot of startups in our region. We are trying to work with them through acceleration programs, but we have